Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. Students, in today's lecture, we shall start our new unit, unit number 4, which is Hazrat Umer radiallahu ta'ala anha. And we will also discuss the new words and their meaning. We shall start the reading first. So open your book to page number 27 and put your finger on the very first line of first paragraph and read aloud with me. Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anha was born in 583 AD in Makkah. He was one of the closest companions of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His name was Umar, and Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him the title of Al-Farooq, meaning the one who distinguished between the right and the wrong. He was the second caliph of Islam. His father's name was Khattab ibn Nawfal. He belonged to the Adi family of the Quraysh tribe in Mecca. He was approximately 13 years younger than Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. He was one of the educated people among the Quraysh at a time when only a few people could read and write. Before accepting Islam, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha was one of the bitterest enemies of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He punished his slaves for accepting Islam. One day, he left his house with intent to kill Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On his way, he met one of his relatives who told him that his sister Fatima and her husband Sayyid bin Zaid both had accepted Islam. Hearing this, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha changed his direction and went straight to his sister's house in great anger. There, he found his sister and her husband reciting the verses of the Holy Quran. First, he fell upon his brother-in-law and beat him severely. His sister tried to stop him. While doing so, she got injured. When Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha saw his sister bleeding, he immediately calmed down. "You may kill us, but we will never leave Islam," said his sister. Hearing this, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha said, "I want to read what you were reading. First, take a bath if you want to read the Holy Quran," his sister replied. So Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha recited the Quran after taking a bath. After reciting the Holy Quran, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha believed that the Quran is a true book of Allah. He rushed directly to Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and accepted Islam. All the Muslims were overwhelmed on his acceptance of Islam. Muslims were a minority in Mecca. They could not say Salah at the Kaaba. But when Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha accepted Islam, they said their first Salah in the Kaaba in his company, as they knew no one dared to challenge Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha. After the death of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anha, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha took over as second caliph. He was a great example of leadership. He followed in the footsteps of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam to the fullest extent. He is known for his bravery and justice in the history of Islam. It was Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anha under whose rule Islam became a great force. He provided easy and immediate justice to everyone. He was an excellent administrator who originated an efficient system of administration. He was the real founder of the political system of Islam. He gave stipends to the poor and children. He introduced rules and regulations and implemented them in the state. There was complete rule of law while he was in office. He improved agriculture and economy. He looked after his people in all aspects. Hazrat Umar Farooq Raziallahu Ta'ala Anha conquered many areas during his caliphate. He conquered grain empires of Rome and Iran. He bought an area of approximately 2,200,000 square miles under Islamic rule during 10 years of his reign. On 27th Zilhajj, Hazrat Umar Raziallahu Ta'ala Anha went to a masjid to lead the Fajr prayer. A non-Muslim slave named Abu Lulu Feroz attacked him and stabbed him several times while he was leading the prayer. The great Caliph of Islam embraced martyrdom on 1st Muharram 24 AH. Students, this was the reading of the unit number 4. This unit of yours is all about our second Caliph of Islam. As we have studied that Hazrat Umar Raziallahu Ta'ala Anha was born in 583 AD in Makkah. He was not Muslim and was the enemy of our Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Once, he was intended to kill Hazrat Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. On the way, his relative told him that your sister and her husband has accepted Islam. Hearing this, Hazrat Umar Raziallahu Ta'ala Anha got too much angry and directly went to his sister's house and tortured his brother-in-law badly. His sister was reciting Quran. So Hazrat Umar Raziallahu Ta'ala Anha also recited. After reciting the Holy Quran, Hazrat Umar Raziallahu Ta'ala Anha believed that Quran is the sacred book of Allah and accepted Islam. Hazrat Umar Raziallahu Ta'ala Anha was second caliph and was a great example of leadership. He is known for his bravery and justice in the history of Islam. On 27th Zilhajj, a non-Muslim slave named Abu Lulu Feroz attacked him and stabbed him several times while he was leading the prayer. The great Caliph of Islam embraced martyrdom on 1st Muharram 24 AH. So students, this was your unit number 4, Hazrat Umar Raziallahu Ta'ala Anha. Now we will discuss the new words of this unit along with their meanings. Okay, so your word number 1 is companion, and the meaning of companion is a friend. Okay, your word number 2 is distinguish, and its meaning is recognize or treat someone or something as different. Your word number 3 is approximately, means close to correct. Your word number 4 is bitter, means very difficult to accept or bear. Word number 5 is slave, and the meaning of slave is a person who is owned by someone. Okay, your word number 6 is intent, and its meaning is intention or purpose. Your word number 7 is overwhelm, and its meaning is overcome by superior force. Word number 8, minority, means a small group of people within a community or country. Your word number 9 is originate, and the meaning of originate is have a specified beginning. Word number 10 is stab, and its meaning is a strong blow with a knife or other sharp pointed instrument. Okay, your word number 11 is embrace, and the meaning of embrace is accept a belief, theory or change willingly. Your last word is martyrdom, and its meaning is death that is imposed because of the person's attachment of a religious faith or cause. Okay, students, so this was your unit number 4, Hazrat Umar رضي الله تعالى عنها. Okay, students, today we discussed the new words and also we did the complete reading of unit number 4. I shall come back with a new lecture. Till then, Allah Hafiz and take care.